Hello students, welcome to this session on the calculation of interest on drawings using average period method. This method can be used only for a periodical withdrawal of money by any partner. So here, if the drawings are done at regular intervals of time, what is regular intervals of time? Let it be monthly, quarterly, or it could be half yearly, and so on. So when the frequency of time is the same, then we can use this method. And this method is popularly called shortcut method. And for irregular intervals of time, this method cannot be used. We have to use either general method or preferably product method. See, there are three steps in the computation of interest on drawings under this particular method. Step number one is calculation of average period. What is average period? It is given by a simple formula. Longest outstanding period plus shortest outstanding period by 2. It is an average of the longest and the shortest outstanding periods. For computing the longest and shortest outstanding periods, unlike product method, we need not have to work on any tables. You just have to analyze the question properly and find out which is the longest period and shortest period and take an average of these two. Step number two is calculation of total drawings, and that would be mentioned in the question itself, and you have to be very careful as to what is the frequency and accordingly multiply with the amount of withdrawal so that you get the total amount of drawings made by any partner. And usually it is computed for a year's period. And the third step would be the computation of the interest on drawings. And again, a simple formula here needs to be learned. Interest on drawings is equal to total drawings into average period into rate into 1 by 12. When you work on this formula, you arrive at the interest on the partner's drawings. Now look at this simple example that is provided to you. Ravi Shankar and Uday Shankar are partners sharing profits equally. Ravi Shankar withdrew regularly rupees 2000 at the end of every month for the half a year ending 30th September 2013. Calculate interest on drawings of Ravi Shankar. I have taken only one single partner's computation here at 10% per annum under average period method. So the problem says that Ravi Shankar has withdrawn money regularly at the end of every month. See, I have told you, usually it should be a year's computation, but sometimes it would be half a year's computation also. So here, it is very specifically mentioned that it is a half a year's computation. Half a year's computation meaning the year starts on 1st of April, but then it ends by 30th September. That is April, May, June, July, August, September, a period of 6 months. Instead of 12 months, we have to compute it only for 6 months. Now here, the question gives you the details that Ravi Shankar withdrew regularly at the end of every month. On which date do we start? I told you, 1st of April. But then, when it is specifically said that the withdrawal happens at the end of every month, so the beginning date of the withdrawal would be 30th April. Instead of 1st April, he is going to draw for the first time on 30th April. So the computation would be from 30th April till 30th September. Usually it is 31st March. All of you know that the financial year end would be 31st March. Since we are computing it for 6 months, I have kept this computational period as 39. That is, the longest outstanding period would be from 30th April till 30th September. Now you know already that April month should not be included because it has a date 30th, the last date of April. So April will not be inclusive, exclude April's month. So you start the count from May onwards. May, June, July, August, September. So what would be the outstanding period here? 5 months. Now come back to the shortest period. Shortest period would be, when did he withdraw at the end? 30th September. So 30th September to 30th September would amount for 0 period. Why? Because 1 day will not be accounted for over here. So therefore, this period would be taken as 0. Now now you have to compute the average for these two periods, 5 plus 0 by 2, that is 5 by 2, 2 and a half months. So for your easiness, you can put it as 2.5 also, because when you work on the calculator, fractions cannot be worked on. So therefore, you can take it as 2.5 as your outstanding average period. Now, step number 2, calculation of total drawings. Now, the question says that Ravi Shankar has withdrawn 2,000 rupees at the end of every month. So, for how many months did he withdraw? For half a year ending. That is, for 6 months he has withdrawn, right from April. Though he has withdrawn on 30th September, he has withdrawn on September month also. So, it includes the month of September. So, necessarily he has withdrawn for 6 months of the year. So, 2,000 into 6, the total withdrawal money would be rupees 12,000. Now let us compute on the third step. The third step specifies total drawings into average period into rate into 1 by 12. Total drawings amounts to 12,000. And average period, we have already calculated. I have used 5 by 2 here for my computation. You can as well put it as 2.52 when you are working on the calculator, or 5 by 2 will also do. Into the rate, rate is 10%. Into 1 by 12. 1 by 12 is again a constant which we have already used in product method. The same 1 by 12 is being used here also under average period method. So you arrive at interest on Ravi Shankar's drawing being rupees 250. Now let us look at another example. Savitri and Bharati are partners sharing profits and losses equally. Savitri withdrew rupees 1,500 at the beginning of each month, and Bharati withdrew rupees 2,000 at the end of every month. And this is going to be for 1 year's period, for the year ending 31st March 2014. Calculate interest on partners' drawings at 12% per annum under average period method. So in the previous example, we have worked out for a period of 6 months. But here we are doing a similar kind of computation for a period of 1 year, that is for 12 months. So here the same steps are followed. The step number 1 would be calculation of average period. So what does the question specify us? That Savitri has withdrawn rupees 1,500 at the beginning of every month. So usually the year begins on 1st of April, ends by 31st March. So here, Savitri has withdrawn, the first withdrawal, her installment would be on 1st of April. So the period between 1st of April till 31st March 2014 would account for the longest outstanding period, which would be for 12 months period. There is a mistake over here. I hope you can follow this. 31.3 it should be. And then when it is shortest outstanding period, again, the withdrawal happens on 1st of March, because again, you read these lines here in the question that Savitri withdrew rupees 1,500 at the beginning of each month. So beginning of each month, when it says beginning, so it should be 1st of March. From 1st of March till 31st of March would account for 1 month. So the shortest outstanding period is considered to be 1 month. So the average period would be 12 plus 1 by 2, which would be 13 by 2. 6.5 months, or you can take it for the computational easiness as 6.5. Now step number 2 would be calculation of total drawings. 1,500 is withdrawn into 12. Into 12 amounts for 18,000 rupees. And then apply the formula. Total drawings into average period into rate into 1 by 12. So the total drawings is 18,000 into average period 6.5, or you can take it as 13 by 2 as it is. And the rate is 12 by 100. 1 by 12 is a constant which you need to use in the formula. So you arrive at Savitri's drawings to be 1,107. Now there is another sub-question. Bharati withdrew rupees 2,000 at the end of each month, right? So here Savitri is withdrawing 1,500 at the beginning. I have shown you the computation. The next part of the question indicates Bharati withdrawing rupees 2,000 at the end of every month. same steps should we have to follow. The first step would be computation of average period. Here, longest outstanding period plus shortest outstanding period by 2. Two things I have changed in this second part of the question. The amount is rupees 2000 and Bharati is withdrawing at the end of every month. I repeat, Bharati is withdrawing at the end of every month. So when I say at the end of every month, again, the first withdrawal would be on April end, that is 30th April. So 30th April till 31st March would amount for a period of 11. And the last withdrawal will be 31st March itself. So 31st March means, again, 31st March to 31st March amounts to a period of 0. So the average period would be calculated as 11 plus 0 by 2, which would be 5.5 months in this case. Total drawings, again, rupees 2000 has been withdrawn for all the 12 months you have to take, whether it is end of the month or beginning of the month, all the 12 months has it been withdrawn. So therefore, we compute it for 12 months period. Now 2000 into 12 would amount for 24,000. The third and the last step, we apply the same formula, total drawings into rate into average period into 1 by 12. So wherein we compute the interest on drawings of Bharati to be 1320. Well, a similar example, Lakita and Chaitra were partners and Chaitra withdrew 5000 quarterly. When I say quarterly, did you observe in all these examples, a frequency of time has been mentioned. In the first example, it is monthly and for 6 months period. In the second example, again monthly and for a period of 1 year. Here, there is an example which says that the partner has withdrawn quarterly rupees 5000 at the end of each quarter, again for 1 year's period of time. Interest is chargeable on partner's drawings at 10% per annum and you may have to compute the interest on drawings using average period method. Remember, a quarter indicates 4 months and 4 times in a year, and there are 12 months in a year. So 12 divided by 4, the frequency is every 3 months. So you have to be very clear on understanding the frequency of quarter. So quarter indicates 4 times a year. 12 divided by 4, 12 months make a year. 12 divided by 4, so the frequency of interval period of time would be 3 months once. So here the largest outstanding period plus smallest outstanding period. And very clearly there is a mention that at the end of each quarter. So you begin the period on 1st of April. So April, May, June, the first withdrawal happens on 30th June. You have to mentally calculate this. So 1st of April, though the year begins, End of each quarter is again 3 months once. So April, May, June, and first withdrawal takes place on 30th June. So the longest outstanding period would be from 30th June till 31st March. June is not accounted. Leave away June, the month of June, and start your count from the month of July. July, August, September, October, November, December, Jan, Feb, and March. A period of 9 months would be the largest outstanding period. When it comes to last withdrawal, the last quarter would be October, November, and Jan, Feb, and March. We are talking about financial year, so therefore January, February, and March. So end of each quarter, which means the withdrawal date would be 31st March. And we are going to compute the interest on drawings till 31st March. So the shortest outstanding period will be from 31st March till 31st March, which would be 0 months. So 9 plus 0 by 2, 4.5 would be the average period. Total drawings, you must be careful here. If it was monthly, I have computed it as multiplied by 12. Here, a quarter is 4 times a year. 3 months once or 4 times a year. So therefore, 5,000 withdrawn quarterly, which indicates the total withdrawal will be 5,000 into 4. That would amount for rupees 20,000. Apply the formula, total drawings into rate into average period. 20,000 into 9 by 2, you can take it as it is, or 4.5 into 10 by 100, which is the rate, into 1 by 12, a constant. So you arrive at 750 rupees. So here, average period method, beginning of each quarter, it would be I've just shown you a sort of calculation over here. 12 plus 3 by 2, the average period would be 7.5 months. If it is end of each quarter, as we have seen in the previous example, 9 plus 0 by 2, which would be 4.5 months. So here you can see some more examples appearing on your screen. I've taken this example for your better understanding. See, the quarterly drawings only, it is slightly difficult to understand the concepts. So I've shown with more examples, that's all. So 2000 has been withdrawn quarterly. And there are four quarters in a year. So 2000 into 4. Always total drawings remains the same. Understand, it is at the beginning or in the middle or at the end of each quarter, whichever is given, the total amount of withdrawal will remain the same. Even if it is monthly, also same thing. Even if the longest period is 11 months, you don't multiply by 11. You multiply by 12 months only. Now here, when you compute, imagining rupees 2, I have kept all the rest of it constant and I am computing the interest on drawings for beginning, middle as well as end of every quarter. Look at this first example where the first slide will help you to understand the first box over there. 2000 rupees has been withdrawn quarterly at the beginning of every quarter. First of every quarter indicates at the beginning of every quarter. So beginning of every quarter here. So the longest period is 12, the shortest period is 3. We have seen this in the previous examples. I'm just reinforcing this fact. So 12 plus 3 by 2, 15 by 2, and that could be 7.5. 1 by 12, you could take it as 1 by 12, or I have put it as 7.5 by 12 directly into 10 by 100, which would be 500 rupees. Now, you're moving to the middle of every quarter. Supposing that sometimes, very rarely, they may ask me that the withdrawal happens at the middle of every quarter. Here, the total amount of withdrawing is the same. Remember, it is 8,000 rupees, 2,000 into 4. Now, 15th of April is the starting period here. So here, what happens is, 15th of April meaning, instead of 12 months, it would be 11.5 months. The largest outstanding period would be 11.5, and the shortest period, instead of 0, it would be 0.5. Why 0.5? Because 15th of March till 31st of March, that would be the range for the shortest period of month. So here 15th of March till 31st of March makes it half a month, which would be computed as 0.5. so 11.5 plus 0.5 by 2, that is again 12 by 2 is 6. So the average period has to be computed as 6. And the rate remaining constant as in the previous example, 10%. So the total interest on drawings would be considered as 400. Actually, these figures were missing in the previous slide as such. So you can see here 10.5 plus 1.5. See, actually, middle of every quarter, it is like 1.5 months after. So 1.5 months after is actually, it should be like 15th of February. Now, February, even though it has less number of days, we do not consider that number of days here. We consider it as a whole month. So instead of here, 12 months, we are going to subtract. How many months we are going to subtract? 1.5 months. Why 1.5 months? 3 months make a quarter. So therefore, 1.5 we are going to subtract, because the first withdrawal, it doesn't happen on 1st of April. It happens in the mid of May. So from mid of May till 31st March is a period of 10.5. And the last withdrawal is 1.5. So it happens on 15th of November. So the computation goes like this. 15th of November till 31st of March would be a period of 1.5 months. So here the average month, it would be 6, 10.5 plus 1.5 by 2, which will result in 6 months. So the rate given at 10%. So here the same computation goes, 8,000 into 6 by 12 into 10 by 100. Now coming to the last of every quarter, here the last of every quarter is like end of every quarter. So the first quarter ends by April, May, June, 30th June. So June is not inclusive. We start the count from July. July till March would be a period of 9 months. and the last withdrawal takes place on 31st March. So 31st March to 31st March is a zero period. So 9 plus 0 by 2 is 4.5. 8,000 into 4.5 by 12 into 10 by 100 would result in rupees 3. So here this particular example will allow you to understand how quarterly withdrawal is happening for the whole year. See, usually when they ask quarterly, it would be again for the whole year. They will not ask you for 6 months period. But if it is a monthly withdrawal, they may ask you either half yearly or it could be yearly also. So you have to accustom with the formula first, the steps which are involved. There are three steps. First step is the computation of average period. The second step is in respect to the total drawings to be computed. And the third step would be the formula application where you compute the interest on drawings. And be careful in the computation of the outstanding periods and understand whether it is beginning of each month or middle or end of each month. Similarly, beginning of every quarter, it can be 6 months once also. Usually, the examples go with either monthly or quarterly. So you can practice using different examples how we are going to compute the interest on drawings using this average period method. Thank you.